5, reads like this: For thou, O God, hast heard my vows. Thou hast given me the heritage of those that fear thy name. And I want to preach today a little while on the heritage. And before I do, I'd like for you to just ask God to touch us in the next few minutes, all of us, and give. And we're glad that you're here. I see Brother and Sister Holmes back there. Brother Holmes, I'm a little lonely up here. Would you just come sit with me up here? I don't have nobody up here with me. Just Sister Johnette, why don't you come up here and sit by Sister Wilson? There's room. You guys, everybody's room on the front row for all of you. This will just make me feel better. Amen. God bless. Everybody says, God bless Sister Holmes.
God bless Sister Holmes.
Amen. Sit right there. Amen. That's good. That's good. Amen. I feel better. Just been through, you know, they look like old fighting dogs. Their old dog face is all scarred up with scratches and bites. Amen. But, you know, it gives you character. It gives you character. Amen. And then Brother Holmes, I've known for, we've been pretty well acquainted for, I look back, I think it's probably been about 25 years now, Brother Holmes. And I heard somebody say something about you the other day, and I just laughed. You want to know what they said?
Man, it's just...
You prayed this morning. You feel it coming. Well, first of all, they didn't know you. Okay. So let me preface that and soften this a little bit. They didn't know you, and I'm a little embarrassed to say this, but they called you Maverick. Maverick. You know what I thought? I thought, that doesn't show a bad person. That shows somebody that doesn't know their apostolic history.
Yes, that's right.
Or they know their apostolic history from a very narrow slice, but they didn't know the bigger picture of apostolic history. And brother, I'm preaching in a little while here about heritage, and brother Holmes has a great heritage. His daddy's picture is around in the Hall of Faith that we still don't have finished, but we have a number of large portraits in there. And his daddy is one of them in the Hall of Faith, because as I got to preaching in churches, primarily throughout the South, church after church after church after church that I went to had an old drum in it, an old bass drum sitting on the platform. Nobody, I don't think, played it except when everybody got all hyped up, then they'd go beat on that drum. And I don't know how many churches there is I've been to and had this old drum. And finally, I made the connection when I went to Brother Holmes years and years ago. It's an old bass drum there. And his daddy used to take an old bass drum. He wasn't a great musician, but he understood worship. And when there wasn't any music to create the kind of worship, or if there was, it didn't matter to him. He would beat that old drum until the Holy Ghost came down. And just insist that there's going to be worship in this place. And out of that spawned revival. They evangelized all over the South. Out of that spawned revival. And then he went years ago and became pastor in Little Rock, Arkansas, North Little Rock. And that's where Brother Holmes and Brother Nathan Holmes, pastor now, a great church. And the contributions this church makes is to apostolic missionaries and people everywhere, regardless of organization, regardless of independence, regardless of any of that. They are great supporters of the work of God worldwide. So these are some of my friends, and I got a lot of friends here today. These are some of my older friends. Not old, just a little old. So, brothers, they're good guys. All right. So I want to preach to you for a little while today about the heritage that you and I have. This scripture, I just love this scripture that says, "For thou, O Lord, hast heard my vows, and thou hast given me the heritage of those that fear thy name." The heritage of those. I have the heritage of those that fear the name of God. And that's a long lineage before I ever got here, a few of which we may talk about a little bit here today, but the heritage of the lineage and the heritage they bring to me of those that fear the name of God, all the way back to Enoch, all the way back to Abraham and Isaac and Jacob, patriarchs, and all of them, and Moses, and on down the line, there is a heritage there. That in that lineage they bring to us that are here today. It's the heritage of those that fear the name of the Lord. Now there's other people in the world, many people in the world that do not respect that heritage, but for you and I that are here today, that heritage, there's nothing more valuable to us than that heritage, that we are among those that fear the name of the Lord. We are the recipients of what that means to have the heritage of those that fear the name of the Lord. And we stand here and sit here today in the presence of God because that heritage has been transferred to us. When I think about that, and when I think about all the people in the world that do not have the heritage of those that fear his name, it makes me want to stop and say, "God, one more time, I just got to tell you how much I love you. I don't deserve this, but I am so glad I am a part of the heritage of those that fear the name of the Lord." And I know you feel that way today. Praise God. That's loving. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.